Now, your latest film, Tamar, Red Roses and Petrol, is an adaptation of Joseph O'Connor's celebrated stage play. What drew you to O'Connor's story initially?
Oh, well, I certainly remember exactly where I sat and what I saw, because it was one of the most gripping plays that I had seen in years. I was immediately attracted to it. It is wickedly funny. You never forget the laughs. And emotionally, just spot on. To me, just a wonderful story about letting people know you love them when they're alive. Being able to tell each other the truth about things, I think, is one of the most important things in life. And it's so difficult. And when I saw the play, I immediately thought about having to turn this into a film, because it really reminded me of my own family. Not that my own family specifically had these issues, but every family has these odd, surprising troubles, issues between themselves that they haven't been able to work out, mostly because of miscommunications. So I felt it was really a worthy subject and a very beautifully done play. And of course, we had to change it a great deal for a film, but the heart and soul of the genius of Joseph O'Connor remains.
Associate producer on the film is, of course, the acclaimed actor Malcolm McDowell, who plays Enda Doyle in Red Roses and Petrol. What sparked Malcolm off to contribute to the making of Red Roses and Petrol? How did that association?
Well, without Malcolm, I've got to say, none of this would have happened. To see a movie called Gangster Number One, quite by chance, invited to the screening by an old Irish friend of mine, F.X. Feeney, a very prominent critic in America. And it turned out this movie starred Malcolm McDowell. And I watched the movie, and as I'm watching it, I thought, oh my God, there's Enda Doyle. But then I thought, how am I going to organize telling Malcolm McDowell that he's Enda Doyle, basically.
So quickly.
Well, what I did was I literally sat there thinking, I have to ask a great question, because FX was going to do a Q&A after the screening with Malcolm. And I thought to myself, it's not just got to be a great question, it's got to be one that he won't forget, so that when I reconnect with him and say, I'm the lady that asked the question, he will remember who I am.
Very good.
Just a little trick of the trade. We were introduced to each other after the screening, and the rest is history. He not only said he would do the movie, but he became the father to the movie. And it was quite an enormous task for him too, but he really motivated all the actors and became the glue that caused it all to happen.
Now, the film's central characters, the Doyles of Dublin, came together as an all-star cast.
We began with Malcolm, and then we had a great actor in mind, Max Beasley, to play Johnny. But he is a somewhat interesting guy in the sense that he is not quick to say yes. And when we finally had a table reading with the entire cast put together, I called him up and I said, Max, Malcolm is going to be playing Enda. Are you ready to come or not? If you don't come, we won't have our cast put together. And he said, are you telling me the truth? Is Malcolm really playing Enda? I go, yeah, he's really playing Enda. You know, why don't you just come over at this and this time and you'll meet him. Boom, there's Max. So that was one of the great moments for me, because it turned out that Max had always been told as a child that he resembled Malcolm McDowell. And in reality, they do look totally like father and son. And it was just one of those things that not only did they look like father and son, but they became father and son in the movie. And they continue to be incredibly close friends. We also had Susan Lynch, a wonderful Irish actress whose work I had known, who Malcolm introduced me to. We also had Greg Ellis, an English actor, but an English actor who's extremely cool with accents, who was able to do Irish perfectly. And then we had this adorable sister of Colin Farrell, Catherine Farrow, who is still a loving and adored friend of mine. And then we also had a wonderful American actress who had grown up studying with Irish friends and an Irish teacher and knew Irish so well that her accent was as good as the other kids in the cast.
Your daughter, of course, Susanna Hoffs of the Bangles, is instrumental in the film's score.
I asked her about some songs, and I had a record of Irish classic melodies, mm-hmm. and one of them was The Water Is Wide. Mm-hmm. And so we began listening to that song, and she really loved it. And in particular, we used that as a thematic song because Max Beasley also loved it. And then Susan Lynch said it was a song that they were singing in her house when she was a kid. And we realized that it was kind of a classic. So that became our starting point. One day, Sean Lawler said, "Tammy, there's this great band, Flogging Molly, playing at a pub down the street. I think you should come over here and hear their music. I really think they'd be great for the movie." I go down there with a bunch of people that are involved in the movie, my choreographer and the production designer, and a bunch of us went over there to see what he was talking about, and they ended up playing all night for us. There wasn't even a decision to make. Their music is the movie.
Movie premieres and with a global distribution. Are you excited about that tomorrow?
Oh my God, it's so exciting. I can't even say the words. We are lucky that we have wonderful distributors, Worldwide Motion Picture Corporation, who saw the movie at the Newport Beach Film Festival, another wonderful festival where we played. And they enjoyed it, and they took us on with great fervor. They're passionate about the movie. I'm so excited about it.
Tamar Sonnenhofs, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. It's always a pleasure to see you.